Hi there, we're back, and we're going to be drawing an object that's a little bit more complicated as a cross contour drawing now. So this is if you want to try the banana drawing, or if you have a form that's turning in space, like a gourd or some other more elaborate object or a man-made object. And the challenging thing here is trying to figure out where the long axis is on the shape. So usually what I'll do with the banana shape is try to orient it so that one end of the banana is pointing more or less at you. You still want to be able to see some of the side and the top, but don't do a side, just a side view of the banana where it's really hard to show the cross contour line. So try to angle it so that one end of the banana is closer to you than the other, and then do a lot of measuring. So I've done a little bit of a light sketch here to try to help me figure out the basic proportions of the banana. I was looking a lot at this shape here between the two ends of the banana and trying to notice how triangular that shape is, and that this end of the banana is further to the right than this end of the banana is. And I might do some extra measurements just to double check, basic height to width. But since there's so few straight lines to look at on this, it's kind of tricky to measure. So do your best. Use the negative shapes to help you look at those interlocking background shapes so that you can compare them to the shape of the object, and you might do some quick measurements of, thickness at different parts to make it look as accurate as possible. Once you get the basic shape pretty well worked out, what I would do is look for the major plane changes. So the banana has sort of a side plane and then a top plane, and it's not as boxy as a regular man-made box would be. There's a little bit of a curve to each one of those planes, but there is an important dividing line where those planes meet, and that's where the angles kind of change a little bit. So I'm going to try to plot those out first, and I'm going to go ahead and kind of darken in my outer contours so you can see the video a little bit better. So again, this. Okay, so we've got kind of the basic shape, like the silhouette. Like if you had to cut that photograph of the banana out, what would that shape be? But then we also need to get these inner contours. These are really important to kind of explain how the planes overlap spatially. And there's another one here. This is a fake banana, you can tell because we've drawn on it. But with a real banana, you might have a more distinct, plane change where that banana broke, or you could peel the banana to make an even more interesting cross contour drawing that's a little more complex, but we're going to kind of keep it simple for this demo. So we've got the long axis of the banana running on a curve like this, which is a little bit tricky. And these lines are what I would consider are longitude lines that are running the length of the banana. And I'm gonna, it seems like it's a little bit sharp angle there. Okay, round it off a little bit. Okay. There's a couple other lines we could bring in. So you might think, like, if there was a seam line on this fake banana, where might that go? You could even think, okay, if I could see through the banana, it's going to come back on the other side. So just try to make these edge transitions as convincing as possible so it does feel like it's going to be curving back toward this end of the banana. And then you might put another line, running right down the top of the banana, even though our drawing doesn't have that. You can add as many lines as you want to kind of help clarify the form here. And then maybe we add another one here that would wrap around toward the end. So here, as I approach this edge, I want to make sure it really feels like it's going to continue around behind there. You could even draw it transparently to start with if it helps you. Okay, I'm going to also maybe darken this a little bit because I'm imagining that's sort of like where the banana was broken off the stem, and there might be a more abrupt kind of angle change there that we can bring our cross contours to meet at that point. Now, the tricky part with the banana sometimes is figuring out what to do with all these plane changes. And I tend to think of the top part of the banana more or less as, at this point, maybe it's kind of close to a horizontal line. It's definitely curved a little bit, but it's more or less horizontal. And then there's, it becomes more of a vertical plane here. So this is kind of a critical plane change right here. And then I'm kind of looking at what's happening on the banana. These lines are starting to angle a little bit more, but they're still more or less horizontal. They're closer to a horizontal than they are to a vertical. And then as it comes around this corner of the banana, it, you know, some bananas will have sort of an angle change here too, but just describe your own particular situation as accurately as you can. And then as the form gets smaller, these lines can get closer together. And then you might even add a few extra ones here to kind of show how foreshortened that belly of the banana is right there. And then there's some other lines that are coming across this way. They're starting to slant down a little bit more as it comes toward the tip. And now we're back to more or less of a vertical plane here. So again, do your best to be as precise as you can with those angle changes. If it helps you to darken the contour, I think I'm going to darken this one a little bit more to make sure that that part of the banana really pops out in front of this part that's a little bit further away. But there's the basics of how to construct a banana.